Okay, so this has been converted into a pirate ship. They've lightened up the load at the top. They leveled the top deck of the ship, removing the forecastle, the pilot's cabin, most of the stern castle, the quarter deck, and the barricado, the physical barrier on the slave ship that kept the captives far away from the ship's weaponry and separated them from the crew. They also lowered the quarter deck. So, changing of the guard, becoming a pirate ship. These adjustments made the ship less top-heavy, more streamlined, provide an open fighting platform. By clearing the deck, pirates imposed a new identity on the ship, one that didn't recognize privilege, one where men elected their own captain and officers. So, there we go. The slave ship has been converted into the party ship, the pirate ship. Pirates badly wanted slave ships because they were fast. There were also warships packed with weapons. Most had 12 to 14 mounted cannons. It had the top technology of the day. Slave ships were built to carry hundreds of people. They had an additional deck to transport captives. This extra space was needed on a pirate ship because it created more room for the large crew's provisions and supplies. The large galleys and industrial-sized cooking pots on board were perfect for feeding 100 or more men. Pirates wanted slave ships, but most didn't want slaves, sometimes because they had ethical objections to slavery, but more often because they didn't have access to slave markets. If there were still captives on board when pirates took a slave ship, they might be given the option of joining the pirates.